Let's take a few minutes to look at the Text Expander preferences. You can access the Text Expander preferences by going up to the Text Expander menu and clicking on Preferences. You can also do it with the keyboard combination, Command Comma, which works in most applications on the Mac. In Text Expander, you can also access the preferences with the Preferences button right here in the toolbar. So I've opened it up. I'm going to go over to the Expansion tab and let's take a look at those. Text Expander by default expands snippets when they're immediately typed. You don't need to hit a space bar or any special keys, it just happens. That's the way I have it turned on and the way the vast majority of users use Text Expander. However, if you wanted to make it so the expansions didn't happen until you hit the space bar or the tab key or some other delimiter, you would do it right here on this top line. You can set it up to keep the delimiter or abandon it later. So if you're going to use a space bar, for instance, you probably want to keep that. If you're going to use something more specialized like a tab key, you're going to want Text Expander to get rid of that after it does the expansion. And you can even set the delimiters over here on the right side. There's some additional options when using Text Expander. The first is to play the bubble sound. I love the bubble sound. It makes me happy and reminds me that I'm saving time, so I'm going to leave that turned on. There's also some options about how it handles images, whether or not it includes HTML data, and running scripts. Text Expander has the ability to run Apple scripts, JavaScripts, and other shell scripts in Text Expander snippets. They're very beneficial if you spend the time to set them up or get one somebody else has created for you. You definitely want to leave that turned on. And you can also set the delay period before it restores the clipboard. As I've gone through these screencasts, I've made most of my snippets in plain text, and that's my preference. I like to keep it simple. But if you want to have formatted text and pictures as your default, you can do that right here. You would just click on that and it would change the default for you. You can also do that on a per snippet basis in Text Expander. We looked at that earlier. You can see this one is formatted for text, but I could go and change it to plain text if I wanted. I'm going to go back to the preferences now by hitting Command Comma. Case sensitivity allows you to set the preference as to whether or not the snippet abbreviations are case sensitive. So if you have to put a capital letter in to make it work or not, this is where you set that. You can change it if you want in this setting. You can also do it right in the snippets themselves. I'm going to go back to the snippet again. You can see it is case sensitive. If I wanted to change that, I could say ignore case. And you can do that on a per snippet basis. Once again, I'm going to hit the Command Comma to bring the preferences back up. And then the last setting is default is to expand snippet groups in, and I have it set for all applications. But if there are certain applications you don't want it to be set in, you can select one of these. And then you can pick an application that you want to exclude from Text Expander snippets. I'm going to turn that off because I use Text Expander everywhere. Moving on, let's take a look at the Options tab of the Text Expander preferences. And this deals largely with capitalization. Text Expander has the ability to automatically capitalize new sentences for you. It can also deal with that problem of double capitals. If you've ever accidentally held down the Shift key just a little bit too long, you know exactly what I'm talking about. You start a sentence and it has two capital letters where it only needs one. Well, Text Expander can watch out for you on that and can automatically eliminate the double capitals at the beginning of a sentence. Text Expander allows you to be quite granular with these rules. Again, you can set specific applications to exclude or include. The Suggestions preference pane allows Text Expander to give you suggestions when it thinks that you should add a new snippet. There's a whole screencast on this and it talks about when Text Expander recognizes words you've typed over and over again and helps you set up new snippets for it. This is also the place where you can have Text Expander notify you when you're typing something that you already have an abbreviation for. The Hotkeys preference pane deals with all of the system hotkeys, and Text Expander does a great job of this. Most of the key application activities can be controlled with hotkeys. Just go in here and set them for whatever features you use the most. Not surprisingly, the Appearance preference pane shows the appearance preferences. You can, for instance, set whether or not Text Expander shows up in the menu bar. And I strongly recommend you do that because the menu bar has so many great options when you click on the Text Expander icon. You can also hide Text Expander in the dock if you want. You can have it launch automatically at login, which you should do if you're using Text Expander, and show the main window at launch. This pane also gives you the ability to change preferences with the display font. The Account preference pane shows a history of the snippets that you've uploaded and stored at TextExpander.com. One of the nice things about TextExpander is they take care of all of your storage of your snippets at textexpander.com. So whether you're using the iPhone or the Mac or even Windows, you're going to be able to access all of that data. This gives you a history. And finally, there's the update pane where you can set preferences about how often the application updates or checks for updates. And if you ever have any questions, you can go down to the bottom of this one and click on the Visit TextExpander website, and it will take you right there.